I have no beginning. I have no end. I am time. Even the most powerful forces in the universe have not harnessed me. I have waited for none, but I take everyone along. And I, and only I, bear witness to the creation and evolution of this world, a world besieged by the forces of the gods against the ungodly. Since time immemorial, the whole of humanity has been troubled by the forces of evil, transpiring to crush goodness. To combat these forces, the Holy Trinity, or the Divine Trimurti, Lord Brahma, the Creator, Lord Vishnu, the Preserver, and Lord Shiva, the Destroyer or Transformer, have often descended their avatars or various forms to protect creation. At one such time, Lord Shiva took the form of the man-monkey to protect and rescue mankind from the clutches of the bitterest battle of all, narrated in the Ramayana. This is the story of the wisest, swiftest, and strongest of all the warriors of God, of Shiva's most endearing avatar, the legend of Pavanputra Hanuman. Once upon a time, deep in the forests of enchantment, lived sage Brihaspati, the divine sage. With him lived the divinely beautiful Panchakastala, whom he loved like his daughter. Young Panchakastala was intelligent, dutiful, and totally devoted to her sage father. And like any other maiden, dreamt of falling in love with her Prince Charming and riding away with him in his golden chariot drawn by 7 white horses into a land of unending happiness. Panchakastala, an adventurous girl by nature, one day decides to explore the forests beyond the river of the Blue Lotus. It was a lovely day. The air was filled with the fragrance of wild flowers and deer musk. All the little creatures of the wild came out to greet her. Panchakastala was so happy. And then, even as she danced on the fresh dew beneath her dainty feet, came the sound of 1,000 horses racing like a roaring tempest.
What lovely animals!
Those are horses, my lovely one!
Of course I know. One day my prince will come on a horse too.
Look how they neigh!
I wonder who those young men are. They are so handsome.
Oh, look how they jump!
Who goes there in my enchanted forest? Seems like newly recruited warriors out to destroy my precious trees and shrubs. And who watches so shamelessly from behind the bushes? Panchakastala, is that you indeed? Go home, you silly little girl. Have you no shame watching young men from behind the bushes?
I was only...
Dare to argue?
Oh, a damsel in distress.
Oh-ho,
let's carry her away. Hey, old man, leave her alone.
See how they ridicule you.
Why you insult me so?
Now you have no right to live in my ashram. For having broken the rules, you will at this moment leave my heavenly abode and live on earth as an ordinary woman.
Oh, father, do forgive me. You know, I love you so much. Who will look after you if I go? Please, please do not banish me. I beg you.
The word is set. I cannot take it back. Get ready to leave.
Will you not bless me too?
May you leave for a noble cause. Be known as Anjana and bring forth a son worthy for all goodness in this world. Go, my child, in peace.
And so it came to be. The divine damsel Panjikastala, now known as Anjana, came to earth in disgrace, but won the hearts of all those around her with her compassion and grace. But the virtuous Anjana waited even now for her Prince Charming. Would he ever come? She wondered.
Will my prince ever come?
Pray, my beauteous damsel, for whom do you string those flowers?
Who are you, monkey man? And why should I tell you?
I'm Prince Veerakesari, pursuing demon Sambasadan. You should not be wandering alone. Come, let me lead you home.
Thank you, brave Veerakesari. Let's make haste, lest he harms the sages. There's a demon uprooting the ashram!
Help! Help! Save us! Everybody, stay here. I shall tackle him.
Who will save you miserable creatures? Just let me have the beautiful Anjana as my bride, and I shall go.
You miserable scoundrel, say your last prayers.
Yeah.
sage Panga, overwhelmed by Veer Kesari's valor, gave Anjana's hand in marriage to him. Anjana had at last found her prince charming. In the splendorous palace by the river, they then lived happily ever after. Their only sorrow was that they were childless for a long time. But Anjana knew she was destined to bring forth a child of great power. One day, as usual, Anjana was praying to Lord Shiva. When suddenly, she felt as though someone had touched her, and it really shook her. She looked up and saw Lord Pavan in a heavenly form.
Anjana, your prayers are answered. Lord Shiva has sent me and also has blessed you to bear a child. He will be strong and powerful, and will symbolize pinnacle of bhakti, virtue, humility, courage and strength, and I shall be his protector. He shall be called Hanuman.
And with the blessing of Lord Pavan, Anjana conceives, and soon time passes. Anjana gives birth to a bonny, bouncing baby, Hanuman, the wonder child.
Narayana, Narayana. Narayana, Narayana.
My lord, your blessings have borne fruit from the womb of Anjana.
Yes, Narad. This is no ordinary child. It is destined to receive blessings from Brahma himself, and will exemplify the highest qualities of life.
Such a lovely child, my lord. Can I please cuddle him?
Come, Parvati. Let's go bless the child.
Welcome, noble sage and mother. Pranam to you. Pray bless Anjaneya, our lovely son.
Henceforth, he will also be known as Maruti, for he shall be as swift as wind, stronger than the mountains, fearless and virtuous.
And bless too, that he may be as wise as my father, the great sage Brihaspati.
Tatasto, so be it.
And so it came to be that Bal Hanuman was blessed with strength and wisdom by Shiva himself. One day, as he was waiting for his food, Bal Hanuman saw a big ripe fruit hanging just outside his window. It was a treat he couldn't resist. So up he leapt out of his cradle onto the tree to pluck it. And then what followed, of course, was divine intervention.
Seems like an asteroid heading my way.
Oh no, my lord. It's only a child.
Indeed. It's Anjaneya, the wonder child. My child? What are you doing out of bed? Oh no! You can't eat the sun. Go home to your mother. Rahu, catch him!
How dare he challenge me!
Help! Lord, help me! Stop! The sun will burn you!
My lord, look! Lord Surya, afraid that he might burn the child, is cooling himself down. Oh, he has almost froze, and the entire universe is turning cold.
Thank you.
my precious little son. Oh, look how Indra's Vajra has injured your sweet little cheeks.
I shall avenge this act by sucking out the very breath of life from this universe. Choking.
We can't breathe.
Oh, mighty Brahma, your entire creation is dying. The angry Vayu has sucked in the entire atmosphere and has shut himself in the cave. Only you can placate him.
Follow me. Let's see what may be the problem. Open up, Vayu. We have all come to calm you.
Go away. No one can cool me down.
Why have you sucked in all the air?
Because Indra struck my child with his Vajra.
My lord, that was the only way to stop the child from swallowing the sun, which he thought was a fruit.
Indeed, Vayu, you have a brave son. I bless him eternal life, strength and wisdom.
I bless you with 100 part of my power, and when you grow up, I shall be your first guru. So be it.
Pavanputra, we all bless you.
Bal Hanuman, blessed with the strength and valor of the gods, traversed the earth and the galaxies beyond, flourishing and growing stronger.
Hey Maruti, come play with us.
See how high I can throw the ball.
Okay, throw it on the moon. Yeah, and bounce it back too.
Okay, so here it goes. Stand back, the two of you.
Look how it flies. Hey, where's it? I can't see it.
I'll bring it back for you.
Look, Maruti has gone to get her ball back.
Bye Maruti, but come with my ball.
Okay, sorry, Nandan. Chale re, chale re, dekho, okay, sorry, Nandan. But some really sumptuous, luscious mangoes.
These are wonderful mangoes. Let's see if they are sweet.
Hey, you thieves! Wait till I get my hands on you. Stop! Hey, stop!
Fly, Maruti, fly! The gardener will beat you to a pulp.
Hey, guys, stop, stop! You'll fall over the cliff.
Help! 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 Help, Maruti!
Hang on, friends! Here I come! Not to fear, I'm here!
That was close!
Wish you could taste those delicious mangoes. Hey, I think we have landed in an ashram.
It's so peaceful here.
They are the gruesome goblins.
way to Struer, run!
Oh no! Here they come again!
Attack! It's been an action-filled day. Time to eat.
Jackfruit, my favorite.
Okay, friends, enjoy your picnic. Got to get home. Milk time.
Stop!
And so, even as the sun rose to herald yet another day, little Maruti was ready with his bag full of new tricks.
Yeah.
You're going to stay still till we get your mother, okay?
Really? Try stopping me!
It was never a dull day for him and his wayward friends.
Okay, take off, Maruti. Let's chase those cows, Maruti. Oh yes, let's do. What fun! Maruti, the village pond. Let's go fishing.
Okay, friends, let's go and have some fun. Got any fish today?
No, my child. It's been a bad day.
Hey, not to worry. I'll find a way.
One peaceful day, in a neighboring village, even as Pavanputra Hanuman and his friends picnicked on luscious bananas, terror struck when least expected.
Rakshas has once again attacked our village. Look, he is tearing our village apart.
Hanuman, go destroy the Rakshas.
Yes, do so and call for me if you need help.
Here I come, you great bully.
Blessed with vigor of the mightiest of the mighty, Bal Hanuman grew from strength to strength each day, his wild ways disturbing the peace of the rishis. He wondered how these old sages remain so still, meditating endlessly, so boring indeed. So he often swung into action, creating chaos in the midst of tranquility. Shiv avatar, Pavanputra Hanuman, was also the savior incarnate, loved by every creature on earth, big and small.
We'll be right back.
The mischievous nature of Pavanputra, Shiva avatar, always got the better of him.
Who dares disturb me? Oh, Pavanputra, may all the divine powers bestowed upon you leave your memory. Only when someone elogizes your greatness and glory will you regain your vigor and vitality.
And so it came to be, the mighty Bal Hanuman, devoid of the powers bestowed upon him, remained the adorable child of his parents.
Narayana, Narayana! My lord, the time has come for Bal Hanuman to bind his soul with that of his future master, Lord Ram, the firstborn of King Dasharath of Ayodhya.
Well said, Narad. Tathastu.
Anjana, my daughter, your unstinted Shiv Bhakti has blessed you with a phenomenal child. It's now time he realizes the presence of his future master in his consciences. Come, my Pavanputra Hanuman, close your eyes and dwell solely on Lord Ram, your master and savior. He will bless you with eternal life. Repeat after me. Om Shri Ram.
Om Shri Ram.
Om Shri Ram.
Om Shri Ram.
Oh, how I miss my child.
It's his destiny, my beloved. It's time he acquires his guru now.
I'll be glad to give him all the knowledge he requires. Send him to me.
Open your eyes, my precious. Get ready to embark on yet another journey.
Mother, you're my teacher. Where else can I go?
The Almighty Surya will bless you with the knowledge of the three worlds. Get ready to meet him.
As you say, Mother. Om Shri Ram. Om Shri Ram. Om Shri Ram.
So it came to be, Shiv avatar, Pavanputra Hanuman, the mightiest being in Triloka, gained wisdom and enlightenment at the feet of Lord Surya, chanting the name of his beloved Lord Rama.
O Lord, I have been chanting the name of my master for the past so many yugas. Please tell me where to look for him.
Look within your noble heart, my child. You will find him there. You now have the knowledge, wisdom and strength, surpassing even those of the gods. Return to earth and seek your Lord. May Ram be with you.
Om Shri Ram. Om Shri Ram. Om Shri Ram. It was in the beautiful Rishyamukh mountain forests that Hanuman found a true friend and indeed his master. Once, while he was there searching for a delicious meal,
"Hello, young one. I am a stranger to these parts, hungry and frustrated because I can't find any fruits here."
"Oh, hello, noble sir. See those trees across the stream? There, you can feast on the sweetest mangoes of the season."
"Well, well, that sounds delicious. And pray, why are you sitting here and grieving all alone? You look royal. Who are you?"
"I am Prince Sugriva, the exiled brother of King Wali, who very unjustly accused me of treason."
"Tell me all about it. I am Hanuman, and maybe I will find a way to help you out."
"Thank you, kind sir. Wali, my brother, was a very powerful and cruel king of Kishkindha. Once, a demon, Mayavi, challenged Wali's supremacy. Wali accepted the challenge and the two of them fought. Mayavi ran into a cave and Wali followed him to put an end to the demon. He asked me to wait outside the cave and instructed me that if he does not return after 15 days, I should consider Wali is killed and should close the cave with a big rock, so that the demon does not come back. I waited nearly a month, and one day, when I saw blood flowing out of the cave, I presumed Wali was killed and closed the cave. The people of Kishkindha crowned me the king. Suddenly, one day, an injured Wali returned home and accused me of usurping his throne. Wali also forcefully took my wife as his new queen, driving me into these forests."
"Dear Sugriv, your tale is surely one of pain and deceit. You have suffered much indignity."
"Look, Hanuman, I see some people beyond those trees. They are coming this way. They appear as hermits, yet seem so regal in their stride."
"Wait here, Prince. Let me check them out."
"Careful, they carry weapons."
"Noble sirs, you don the demeanor of regal kings, yet traverse these jungles like fearless warriors. Who are you? My heart tremors with the anticipation of your answer."
"Noble Brahmin, we are the exiled princes of Ayodhya. This is Ram, and I am his younger brother, Lakshman. Who are you, who speak to us with such devotion and love?"
"Hey Ram, at last I have found you." "O Lord, you have taken such a long time to come to your devotee, and this Hanuman could not recognize you. I am such an ignorant fool indeed. You have been the very reason of my birth, and the mighty Surya himself has prepared me for this auspicious moment. Accept me as your humble servant, my lord, and never leave my side."
"Pavanputra Hanuman, indeed, your bhakti transcends even those of the greatest ascetics. May the powers of heaven be showered upon you." come. Rise, O son of the winds, and help us seek my beloved Sita, abducted by a demon. We have been wandering in this wilderness searching and have found no trace of her. My heart cries out for her.
O my Lord, say no more, for I do not want you to relive the pain. It's now my life's mission to unite Ma Sita with you and crush the demon and his breed.
Shabri suggested that we take Sugriv's help to find her.
Say no more, my Ram. I am Prince Sugriv's emissary. Unfortunately, he himself lives in exile in these parts with his trusted lieutenants, persecuted by his own brother, King Vali. Come, let me lead you to him.
Hanuman took Ram and Lakshman and introduced them to Sugriv.
Help us to find Ma Sita, Prince Sugriv.
Hanuman, my friend, of course I will. If only I could win back my kingdom, my entire force could be at your disposal.
Dear Sugriv, we will help you regain your kingdom. Oh, how I wish I knew where dear Sita is.
Perhaps I can give you a clue. I heard the cries of a damsel in distress a few days ago. Maybe she was Ma Sita. Look, I have this piece of cloth thrown from an airborne chariot I saw soaring away in the southern sky.
Ah, that belongs to my Sita. How she must be suffering.
Wait till I get my hands on that demon.
Lakshman, let us strategize our way into Kishkinda first and regain the empire.
Yes, Sugriv. Let's not waste another moment. I have a plan. You go to Wali's court and challenge him to a duel. Persuade him to come into the forest alone.
Surely he will be furious, but I will convince him.
Well. Look, who walks so bravely and unarmed into my court?
Wali, your time has come to meet your maker.
How dare you talk to me so, you impudent being?
This kingdom belongs to both of us, you greedy fellow. And if you disagree, then let's fight a duel in the forest beyond. Just you and me. Do you have the courage, you coward?
How dare you challenge me, you traitor? Before sunrise, your head shall roll down the Kishkinda mountains.
Wonderful. So tomorrow morning, before the cock crows, be there.
Let him pass. Come on, you conspirator.
Say your last prayer, brother.
The two brothers. Rama takes position behind a tree, but he's confused because he cannot distinguish between the two of them.
Lord, why did you not help me?
Please do not mistake me. You and your brother look so alike. Now, wear this garland and challenge him again for another duel.
Hey Ram, you are known as the Maryada Purushottam, yet you attack and kill from behind in deceit?
Not as deceitful as coveting a brother's share of the kingdom and his wife. Go in peace, Vali. Your virtuous son Angad will find true glory to compensate your treachery.
I declare you my chief of army. Go forth, put together the best of my soldiers and find Ma Sita.
Hanuman, directing the platoon of monkey soldiers and soldiers, get them to spread out in all four directions, and Hanuman leads his battalions southwards.
Hey Ram.
Sri Ram, I hear someone crying for help. I think it's coming from behind those bushes.
Oh Jatayu, what happened to you?
My Ram, you have come to bless me. Even though I failed you, I tried my best to save Ma Sita. But that Rakshas riding in his flying chariot proved too strong for my feeble body. Go, my Ram, and save Ma Sita. She is crying out for you. Her heart broke over my plight even as I tried my best to save her. He cut my wings and I could do nothing but fall to earth.
My dear Jatayu, is he some Rakshas king?
Yes, I'm very sure he is a Rakshas king. He was heading south.
Rest in peace, Jatayu.
My lord, permit me to go ahead and direct the soldiers. You and dear Lakshman rest in this camp. Sugriv, Angad and Jambavanta will accompany me in my mission.
So be it, Hanuman. Go find Sita and give her this precious ring. She will recognize you as my emissary.
Jai Sia Ram!
Hanuman and the others reached the southern tip and were facing the vast ocean. Hanuman and his troop looked dejected, not knowing what to do.
Easy prey.
Alas, my heart goes out to the brave and noble Jatayu, who fought so valiantly to save Sita.
As Sampati hears about his brother, he suddenly appears before Hanuman, looking all astonished and very distressed.
What? My brother Jatayu is dead? While his unfortunate brother Sampati still lives on.
Do not grieve, Sampati. Jatayu breathed his last in the arms of Lord Ram. We will not let his sacrifice go in vain. We seek Sita, who was abducted by a Rakshas king, who drove a flying chariot. If only we knew she was safe.
Did you say Rakshas king in his flying chariot? It must be the Lankeshwar king Ravan. They say he is immortal, blessed by Shiva himself. If only I could cross the seas to destroy the murderer of my brother, I can verily help you by locating Devi Sita. Let me see. Yes! Yes! I can see a beautiful lady clad in saffron sitting desolately under a flowering tree, surrounded by ugly female guards.
That's Sita Ma, certainly. I wish I could fly out and reach her in one leap.
Hanuman, of course you can. You have great powers bestowed upon you. You can fly and cross vast oceans, mountains and skies. Meditate on your master and receive your vigor. It's time you made use of it.
Then let it be so. May the grace of my master revive my strengths.
Om Shri Ram. Om Shri Ram. Om Shri Ram.
Hanuman, rise now and test your power.
That was most invigorating. Time now to fly to the lair of that Rakshas Ravan and destroy Lanka with him.
Hanuman leaps into the air and flies high.
To fit my size! Ha ha ha!
Look what we have here!
Hey you! Fly right into my mouth! I won't hurt you! I'll just swallow you! Ha 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 ha!
Well said, my beauty! Here I come!
And he flies right into her mouth and comes out of it in an instant. The Rakshasi, angered by this, blows him away with her breath, and Hanuman moves on. Hanuman is flying in the sky. There is a storm brewing in the horizon. He sees a large sea monster like a dragon splashing around. Hanuman flies around it at supersonic speed. The monster tries to gobble him, but Hanuman catches him by the tail swings him around several times and throws him in the air. The sea monster lands in the water with a thud, displacing the ocean. Hanuman arrives at the city's gateway. Hanuman reduces his size and watches from behind a tree outside the city gates. A soldier on a chariot orders the citizens to enter the closing gates because it's sunset. Then Hanuman quickly climbs onto the chariot and hides. Hanuman looks here and there and raising his eyebrows in surprise.
I wonder where Ma Sita could be.
As Hanuman reaches inside, he is astonished to see glittering lights and prosperity all around him. Hanuman is pleasantly surprised. He leaps into the beautiful garden to investigate. He jumps onto a window ledge and peeks within. Astonished to see a regal man worshipping his Lord Ram. He enters and turns into his true form. Vibhishan turns back and sees Hanuman. Hanuman is deeply impressed in the spirituality of the moment.
Open your eyes, my son. Who are you? And why are you here?
I am Ram Bhakt Hanuman and was drawn when I heard you chant my Lord's name.
Alas, it is forbidden to even utter Ram's name in Lanka. Oh, it's my misfortune that the Lankapati happens to be my brother.
Surely then, you will agree that he has committed a mortal sin by abducting his pious wife. Please help me find her.
She lies desolate and inconsolable, guarded by vicious female demons. Ravan wants to take her as his wife, but he cannot touch her because she is surrounded by the fire of her piety. Ravan's wife Mandodari and I are her only sympathizers. If you have the courage, then come. I shall guide you there. Be warned though, none have come out alive from there.
On the guidelines of Vibhishan, Hanuman reaches Ashoka Vatika in a small form. There is a huge Ashoka tree full of white tiny flowers with red stems in the middle of the garden. Under it, Sita was sitting surrounded by ugly female guards. Hanuman jumps blithely from branch to branch, silently till he has Sita in direct vision.
Hey lady, I beseech you to eat. Believe me, no good will come from defying the mighty Lankapati. Even the pious Mandodari, his wife, is unable to influence him.
Leave me alone, please. I'd rather die than submit to that rakshas.
Shh! Here comes Ravan.
Hanuman bends down and sees them approaching from between the branches.
Sita, I can't wait anymore. Be my wife willingly, for your Ram exists no longer. Look! Look, here is his head!
As Ravan unveils the object in the platter, Sita closes her eyes, meditating on Ram. Even Hanuman above the trees looks surprised at the scene. But it turns out to be Ravan's head on the platter. Ravan is stunned to see his own head. Sita opens her eyes and smiles. The guards are shocked and drop the platter.
Oh, go away, you coward brute! How can you even think of harming my lord? You need to protect your own head first.
My lord, I plead you to free her. Don't you realize that her piety will crush you?
Don't challenge me, Mandodari. I will have her at any cost.
As Ravan takes a step forward to grab Sita, she clutches the grass in her hand to protect herself. And because she is so pious, her piety gives power to the gods, and a circle of fire engulfs her, preventing Ravan from touching her. And then he begins singing the glories of Lord Ram. Hanuman looks at her. He remembers the ring Ram gave him. He drops it in front of her and then watches to see her reaction. Hanuman descends to the ground and stands before Sita. Joining his hands and bowing his head in salutation, Hanuman convinced Sita that he is genuinely the messenger of Lord Ram.
Fear not, Ma Sita. I am Ram Bhakt Pavanputra Hanuman.
So, my Ram has thought of rescuing me at last?
My Lord has been depressed without you, Mother. He has been searching high and low for you. It was only through Sampati, Jatayu's brother, we came to know your whereabouts.
The poor, brave Jatayu, is he well?
He breathed his last in Ram's arms.
Alas, he gave his life for me. Hanuman, when will my Lord take me away?
As soon as I get back with the news of your well-being, he will be here with the monkey brigade. But before that, there is some unfinished business with Ravan.
I am so happy, Hanuman.
Mother, may I eat some of these delicious fruits in the meantime? I am hungry.
Go ahead, they are all yours.
After getting permission, Hanuman looks around and starts shaking the fruit-laden trees to eat fruits and satisfy his hunger and quench his thirst. A guard starts to chase him. Hanuman runs around, teasing them, uprooting trees around him. Suddenly, he increases in strength.
See who helps you.
My lord, a terrible giant monkey has rampaged the Ashok Vatika. He is inexorable.
Indrajit, my son, go forth and arrest the rampaging monkey and bring him to me.
At once, father.
Indrajit gets on his chariot and heads towards Hanuman and challenges him. Indrajit discharges the Indrastra at Hanuman. Hanuman allows himself to be bound by the Indrastra. Hanuman is brought into Ravan's court. Ravan is amused at seeing him. All courtiers are laughing.
A rioting monkey? How dare you go berserk in my vatika? Who are you and where do you hail from?
Lankeshpati, I am Ram Bhakt Hanuman with a message from the Lord himself. Free Sita with full honor and he will not destroy you and your Lanka.
I admire your cheek, you miserable monkey. You ask a favor with such audacity? Why should Sita live with that hermit Ram when I can give her a kingdom of gold?
Hey Lankesh, of what use is your gold when you don't have the blessings of Sri Ram?
Do not mention that name in my presence. I have abducted his beautiful wife only to avenge Lakshman for cutting my Surpanaka's nose. But before that, guards, behead this monkey and parcel it to his master.
Wait, Ravan. He's Ram's ambassador. It's improper to kill him.
And where are your manners, Ravan? You haven't even offered me a seat.
A seat, indeed? Make your own arrangement.
Okay, thank you so much indeed.
Hanuman's tail begins to grow and grow, coiling into a huge pile. Everyone is surprised. Ravan is shocked. Hanuman jumps and sits on the coiled tail. Seeing this, Ravan roared with anger and orders his soldiers to set fire on his tail.
Ha! Guards, set his tail on fire!
Hanuman is amused at the order and smiles. The demons take him out of the court towards the city. Finally, the demon set fire to his tail. Hanuman is unaffected with all this.
Jai Sia Ram!
Hanuman flies over the ocean and puts his tail in the water to extinguish the fire. Then Pavanputra Hanuman crosses the ocean and reaches his home. Ram and Lakshman, accompanied by Jambuvanta, Sugriv and Angad, are anxiously waiting for his return.
Hanuman, tell me, how is my Sita? Is she disappointed that I did not rescue her?
Master, she is alive indeed and protected too by her fire of piety. Yet her life has no meaning without your grace. Her soul yearns for you. Every single moment she calls for you. My heart bleeds for her. My lord, let us start at once and bring her back.
Hanuman, gather your armies of monkeys and remember, we are all equal in the eyes of God. March together till the tip of the land and prepare a shivling for me to worship.
As you wish, my lord. We all will pray to the sea god. I am sure he will give us a way to cross the ocean.
To cross the mighty ocean, Ram and Lakshman prayed to the sea god for 7 days and nights. After days of praying, there was no sign of any help. Then Lord Ram decided to dry the ocean with the Ram Ban. As he reaches for the arrow, the sea god appears before him.
Sri Ram, make a bridge out of stones, but on every stone your name should be written. With the power of Ram Nam, the stones will float on the water, giving you the passage to cross the ocean. You will have blessings of all the gods and goddesses, and you will succeed.
Jai Siaram. Come, let's begin.
Bolo! Bolo Siyavar Ramchandra ki jai!
Siyavar Ramchandra ki jai! Pavanputra Hanuman ki jai! Bolo Bolo Siyapati Ramchandra ki jai! Pavanputra Hanuman ki jai!
With enthusiasm and untiring efforts of the monkeys and all beings around, a strong bridge came upon the sea in no time. The guard runs into the palace and informs Ravan of an army approaching the city.
My lord! We detect a huge army base camp outside our walls.
So Ram, you have come to meet your end.
Vibhishan, go warn Ram of the consequences if he dares attack Lanka. Ask him to retreat immediately, before I destroy each one of them.
Brother, the Lord himself has come to your kingdom. Honor him and be blessed. Give him back his consort and defuse this situation.
You traitor! Get out of my sight before I destroy you too. Go, join your Lord and betray your own kingdom.
Sugriv, Angad, Hanuman and Jambuvanta are conferencing. Hanuman watches as Vibhishan comes. Hanuman embraces him and introduces him to Ram. Vibhishan greets Ram with respect and tells him how Ravan threw him out of Lanka and he seeks the Lord's mercy.
Sri Ram, Vibhishan can help us invade Lanka.
Yes, but before that, Angad, ask Ravan to give up Sita and foster peace.
As you say, my lord.
Angad was sent to Ravan's palace as an emissary of Lord Ram.
Who are you?
I'm Angad, son of your good friend Bali. I'm a messenger of the Lord.
Angad stands proudly, reading out the peace treaty.
What peace are you talking about, Prince Angad? Go tell Ram to come fight for his Sita.
Ravan, seek Ram's forgiveness. Return Ma Sita to him and save your life.
Catch hold of that stupid mantra and throw him out.
If possible, catch me.
Jai Siyaram.
Prepare for war. Wake up. Wake up Kumbhakarna and ask him to lead the battalion.
To war!
The attendants blow trumpets vigorously and beat the drums to awaken Kumbhakarna.
Kumbhakarna, go to war and lead the battalion.
I obey your order.
Thank you.
Salutations to you. I would like to see you in better circumstances. Why are you here?
As you're not aware, brother, Ravan has ordered me to meet my death.
So, you are aware that you can't defeat Ram? Then why? Why are you doing this?
I'm obeying Ravan's orders.
Why don't you join Ram and oppose Adharma?
You've always been a just and fair person. As for me, Ravan is my god. I obey his orders, even if it means opposing Dharma.
Do not do this. I can't bear to see you perish, because I've seen the death of my near and dear ones. I don't want to lose you. I love you very much.
I know that, dear Vibhishan, but now we are on opposite sides of the fence. I will not hesitate to kill you if you oppose me.
If my death can desist you from this foolish act, then I'll be glad to leave my life before you.
I can't help you, dear. I love Ravan too and can't let him down.
Isn't there something that I can say or do that will stop you?
No. Do not weep over my fate. I am going to meet my end at the hands of Lord Vishnu incarnate.
So you know.
You must be Lord Ram.
Yes, I am.
Salutations to you, my lord. I will have the honor of dying at your holy hands.
There is no reason for you to die if you have realized who I am.
I have only one request. I want my head to fall on the ocean bed which has raised me. That will be my last wish.
Your wish will be fulfilled.
Ravan was terribly depressed by Kumbhakaran's death.
Go, avenge your uncle Kumbhakaran's death. Use your Brahmastra if needed, but only wisely. For remember, it can be used only once.
At once, father.
Ram, Indrajit's arrow has fatally wounded Lakshman.
Oh, my brother Lakshman, you cannot leave me and go. Wake up. Oh, please open your eyes.
Vibhishan instructs Hanuman to bring Sushina from Lanka.
Master?
master, the great physician Sushena is here.
Dear sir, please save my beloved brother.
My lord, through your grace, Prince Lakshman still breathes faintly. Alas, the Brahmastra is fatal. Only the magical Sanjeevani herb found on the slopes of the treacherous Mount Gandhamadana can save him. I need it before sunrise tomorrow.
Hanuman, only you can bring it before daybreak. Go at once.
My son, look out for a golden creeper which blinks throughout the day and night.
Cast aside your anxieties, Lord Rama. Lakshman will see the sunrise with us tomorrow.
The Himalayas are very far away on the north side, and time was very short. Hanuman doesn't stop a while until he reaches the Himalayas. Sanjeevani herb, he decides to take the whole mountain itself.
Why hasn't Hanuman returned till now?
Forgive me, Master. I could not recognize the herb, so I brought the whole mountain.
Only your bhakti can truly move mountains, Hanuman. Sushina, please search for the herbs and bring my Lakshman back to life.
Then Sushina, the physician, plucks the flower, crushes the juice out of it, and applies it on the wounds of Lakshman. As the first rays of the sun reaches his prostrate body, when the sun rays reach his eyes, he opens them.
Shri Ram. Lakshman, my brother, Hanuman has given you a new birth.
Siyavar Ram Chandra ki jai, Pavan Putra Hanuman ki jai.
The war resumes. Indrajit enters his chariot and heads towards Lakshman from the sky. Lakshman aims the arrow at Indrajit. Suddenly, Indrajit disappears from Lakshman's sight, laughing. Then Hanuman lifts Lakshman to the sky. Lakshman employed Investra and discharges the fatal arrow. Indrajit rolls down to the ground.
Jai Siyaram.
Mandodari hears her son's cries and rushes to Ravan's court, and she pleads with him to end the war.
My lord, please put an end to this carnage. I've already lost my son. I don't want to lose you.
Mandodari, do not discourage me from fighting. Don't worry about me. Ram, now prepare to fight with me.
Now the furious Ravan himself appeared on the battlefield in his chariot like a god of death and brought havoc among the enemy forces. The monkey army begins running helter-skelter.
Hey Dashrath Putra Ram, be prepared for your end. I shall avenge my son's death before sunset today.
Your arrogance and pride have cost you so much destruction, Ravan. You could have made so much use of your knowledge of the scriptures and statesmanship. But it was not to be. So, you too be prepared for the consequences.
Ram and Ravan take aim at each other and shoot their arrows. The arrows meet and explode with light. Arrows on the demon king. Even as Lord Ram knocked off their heads, they soon grew back in their places. Ram is perplexed. Then suddenly, Ram remembers that Vibhishan told him the secret of Ravan's navel. When Ram shoots the arrow into his large navel, Ravan falls to the ground with a resounding thud.
Hanuman, you are form of Lord Shiva. How could not I recognize you? Shri Ram, you are form of Lord Vishnu. Thank you for liberating me. Forgive me for my sins and bless me.
Vibhishan, the cremation of Ravan should be done with all honors.
Hanuman, take Ram and Lakshman to Ashok Vatika.
Hanuman takes them to Ashok Vatika, where Sita is awaiting with a garland in her hands. As Ram and Sita embrace, there is a shower of flowers from the heavens above. Hanuman could not stop his tears.
Sita, forgive me for the delay in rescuing you.
My lord, I have counted every moment for this.
We are united forever, Sita. Thanks to my greatest devotee, Hanuman. Oh Hanuman, you are my greatest devotee. What should I offer you? Your devotion to me cannot be described in words, nor can it be compared with any other. Your name shall always be taken along with mine. From now, you will be known as Veer Hanuman and Sankat Vimochak, waver of disaster and distress.
Hanuman, thank you for all your bravery and wisdom. Sri Ram, definitely wish you to be with us always.
Thank you, Mother. I know for sure my heart is full of His presence and grace.